ना सर, तो थोड़ा हो जाता है, नोट्स कलेक्ट करते वक्त थोड़ा इशू होता है,
क्या इशू होता है?
आगे पीछे हो जाता, लिखते लिखते अगला पॉइंट आपका स्टार्ट हो जाता, हम पीछे रह जाते नहीं तो। थोड़ा थोड़ा हो जा, पर हो जाता है सर, कवर कोई इशू।
हाँ, तो दैट्स व्हाई आई एम रिकॉर्डिंग द लेक्चर एंड शेयरिंग ऑन योर गूगल क्लासरूम। तो
यस सर,
वेयर एवर यू लेफ्ट, यू कैन ऑन योर वीडियो लेक्चर एंड यू कैन मेक योर नोट्स। ऑल्सो
सर
आई विल प्रोवाइड द लेक्चर मटेरियल टू यू एज
ओके सर,
वी विल प्रोसीड इंशाल्लाह, है ना। एंड आई विल प्रोवाइड द MCQs ऑन यूनिट नंबर 1 एंड यूनिट नंबर 2 PDF। वी विल स्टडी एंड देन वी विल वन सेशन वी विल पुट फॉर द क्विजेस एंड आई विल आस्क द आंसर्स टू यू एंड वन बाय वन यू हैव टू आंसर,
ओके सर,
है ना। तो दैट विल
ओके
हेल्प
सर,
यू फॉर योर प्रिपरेशन इन फ्यूचर। नाउ योर
ओके
एग्जामिनेशन मे बी फ्रॉम 26 आई थिंक सो और 27।
मेन फाइनल पेपर सर,
दिस हाँ दिस फॉर एंड सेमिस्टर फॉर फर्स्ट फर्स्ट सेम।
फर्स्ट सेम इट्स 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 5 days सर।
अच्छा, तो यू आर गेटिंग अ PL फॉर 1 week, है ना, बिकॉज
यस
दिस
सर, यस सर,
ऑनलाइन लेक्चर्स विल बी रन अप टू 26 ऑफ दिस मंथ ओनली। ओके ओके, देन आफ्टर दैट वी विल स्टॉप एंड देन अगेन रिज्यूम। तो
यस सर,
सिंस लॉन्ग टाइम वी आर नॉट टच विद द कॉन्क्रीट टेक्नोलॉजी ड्यू टू यूर इन सेम एग्जामिनेशंस। आई
यस सर,
होप सो यू हैव डन गुड वर्क इन दैट। नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट, वी विल टेक द रिविजन वॉट एवर वी हैव फिनिश टिल डेट एंड देन वी विल प्रोसीड, बिकॉज ऑलरेडी 2.5 units आर फिनिश्ड। तो प्लीज म्यूट यूअर माइक, इफ यू हैव टू से समथिंग देन ओनली अनम्यूट एंड देन आफ्टर सेइंग देन म्यूट दैट। बट ड्यूरिंग द लेक्चर अवॉइड, इफ यू आई विल आस्क सम क्वेश्चन टू समवन देन ही विल अनम्यूट एंड टॉक विथ द क्लासरूम।
ओके सर,
तो दिस लेक्चर ऑन फिजिकल क्लासेस वी हैव डन सम लेक्चर्स अराउंड 14 लेक्चर्स इन क्लासरूम, बट ड्यू टू द वर्स कंडीशंस इट इज़ नॉट एबल टू कंटिन्यू द फिजिकल क्लासेस। दैट्स वाई द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस वी आर रनिंग। एंड यूनिट नंबर 1 एंड पार्ट ऑफ यूनिट नंबर 2 वी हैव फिनिश्ड ऑन फिजिकल क्लासेस बाय कीपिंग द ऑल कोविड प्रिकॉशंस। तो स्टिल द फ्रॉम लास्ट 1 year एंड एनी मोर देन 1 year वी आर इन दिस पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन। इन बिटवीन द सिचुएशन इज गुड देन अगेन इट इज वर्सन। नाउ डेज इन महाराष्ट्र इट इज़ वेरी अलार्मिंग सिचुएशन। यू कैन नॉट से महाराष्ट्र बट ऑल ओवर इंडिया द सिचुएशन इज़ वेरी वेस्ट। That's why the online classes and online examination is running by the universities and colleges. So today we will see the revision of that 2.5 unit we already finished. So in the first unit, the introduction of concrete and the ingredients of concrete. So we know that the main binding material or ingredient material of concrete is Sambhuna Pongal, your roll number. So concrete, in concrete the three basic ingredients are there, that is cement, aggregate and water. And then for getting the improvement in the properties, वी आर डिवाइडेड द एग्रीगेट इनटू टू पार्ट्स. वन इज द फाइन एग्रीगेट, द पार्टिकल लेस देन 5 mm, वी कैन से 4.75 mm एज पर आवर आईएस कोड, एंड पार्टिकल मोर देन 4.75 mm, दैट इज 5 mm अप टू द 20 mm फॉर सब कॉन्क्रीट, एंड मोर देन दैट ऑल्सो वी आर यूजिंग एज पर द आवर रिक्वायरमेंट. तो फॉर इम्प्रूवमेंट वी हैव डन दिट, एंड मैनी कॉन्क्रीट्स मे बी वी आर यूजिंग ओनली बाय द फाइन एग्रीगेट, एंड सम कॉन्क्रीट दे आर कॉल्ड एज स्नो फाइन्स, दो वी आर यूजिंग फॉर पोरस कॉन्क्रीट. तो इन दैट द सीमेंट इज द मेन इन्ग्रीडियंट डेट बाइंड द एग्रीगेट when we add water to the this mixture. When we mix the aggregate and cement together, it will not get binded till we add water, because the chemical reaction will takes place and paste formation only when we add the water. So humne pehle unit mein padha ke what is cement, how it is manufactured, the process of manufacturing. We have seen the dry process, semi-dry and wet process. Also we have seen the composition of cement and hydration reaction. Also we have seen the physical and mechanical properties of cement. Then also we have seen the different types of cement we are using, and different tests we are carried out to check the cement proper or not. It may be the laboratory test, it may be the field test. And also we have seen the aggregates, their types, their classification, what are the deleterious materials in the aggregate, alkali aggregate reaction, and the gradation of aggregate using sieve analysis, etc. we have seen in the classroom. Then the second third most important ingredient, that is water. We have seen the water we are using for the concreting, mixing and curing is it should be free from the harmful ingredients and the suspended matters. So I think so these three are the basic ingredients, but due to the improvement of the technology and need and requirement of the engineers and the requirements of the customers and the need for the infrastructure development, for the large span and bridges and large span structures constructions, we need high strength concrete, and that leads to add some other material to improve the properties of the concrete, and that additional material in the concrete is called as admixtures. So admixtures generally added in the concrete to improve the performance of your concrete, to improve the concrete properties in fresh as well as in hardened state, also to improve the performance of concrete for different purposes such as underwater concreting, for industrial flooring, such as self compacting concrete and other lightweight concretes, high density concrete, etc. There, because the performance or requirement of concrete for different purpose, different properties are needed to be fulfilled. And
excuse me, sir.
By using Haboli.
Sir, is there any list of admixtures?
Yes, we have the code for admixture. We cannot you can make the list of admixture, because many such brands are available into the market. When we'll go to the website, just and you will search, many such admixtures are there. In your IS code also, you will get many such admixtures. And you can search the different new admixtures in the concrete. So it may be available. Videos are also available. Images are also available. And chemical and mineral admixture, mainly those two types are there. I'm coming to that point. So admixtures are added for to fulfill the certain requirement, because some admixture they will accelerate the curing of your concrete, or some may retard the curing time or a setting time. So that's why to accelerate a setting time and to retard the setting time, it is the need of us. If you are doing the concreting underwater, then you have to accelerate the setting time. And if you are doing the concreting in the hot weather condition, you have to retard the setting time. So it may be for different purposes, we need different types of admixtures, and they generally classified as a chemical and mineral admixtures. So mineral admixtures are nothing but the fly ash. It is a byproduct from the thermal power plant. Because the pozzolanic material, it contains the silica in large quantity, which is useful for the concreting, and when it will react with the cement, they are giving the good strength and improved properties. Also, fly ash having a spherical shape, so during freshly mixed concrete, they will act as a ball bearing, and the workability is the enhanced. Similarly, silica fume and ground granulated blast furnace slag. Because slag we are getting from the iron industries, that is the byproduct of the iron study, it is in the part of the aggregate, and you have to grind it in the fine powder to get that is useful for our concreting purpose. And nowadays slag cements are also we are using, and many cement production in India and abroad, they are using fly ash in cement manufacturing also. So that you, as per your cement, and as per that you will use your mineral admixture to improve the properties of your concrete in fresh and hardened strength. हम fresh strength जब मैं बोलता हूँ तो वहाँ पर workability main property है, जिसको हम लोग, it is nothing but workability of concrete is nothing but ease of mixing, transportation, placing, compaction. These all come under the workability of your concrete in the fresh state. And in hardened state, if you will go, the properties of concrete is the strength, and all other properties depend on the strength. So strength is the basic and property in the hardened strength. When I will say the hardened strength property, that is the strength, it may be the flexural strength, bending strength, or the split tensile strength or tensile strength of your concrete. Now in next second lecture, before that I will say that there are chemical admixtures also. We are used in very thin quantity, very less quantity, to improve the properties of your concrete. They are accelerator, retarders, plasticizers, and super plasticizers. Nowadays, we are using super plasticizer, and the plasticizers or super plasticizers, or you can say the chemical admixtures or admixtures, they are added based on the quantity of cement. So 0.1% of cement quantity we are added the chemical admixtures as the required maximum 0.2%. As the requirement we are using the quantity of your chemical admixture. In unit number 2, we have studied about the process of production of your concrete from batching to the curing of your concrete. Batching means measuring the ingredients of concrete by weight. पहले क्या करते थे लोग, एक बॉक्स बना लेते थे, एक सीमेंट बैग का, दो सीमेंट बैग का, हाफ बैग का, एंड 1, 2, 4, 1, 3, 6, 1, 4, 8, इस तरह नॉमिनल मिक्सेस लेते थे और उससे कंक्रीट बनाते थे, जिससे कि बहुत प्रॉब्लम होता था और कंक्रीट का जो आउटपुट एंड में चाहिए वो हमको बड़ी डिफिकल्टी से मिलता था, क्योंकि अगर मॉइस्चर कंटेंट है, वाटर पहले से अवेलेबल है एग्रीगेट में, तो बल्किंग ऑफ सैंड होता था, सैंड जितनी चाहिए उससे कम यूज होती थी, तो डेट्स वाई डिफरेंट इफेक्ट्स आर डन ड्यू टू नॉमिनल मिक्सेस. तो उसके लिए नॉमिनल मिक्सेस को हटा कर व्हाट वी आर डूइंग नाउ इज द डिज़ाइन मिक्सेस वी आर यूजिंग, यानी बाय वेट ऑफ इंग्रेडिएंट ऑफ सीमेंट सॉरी कॉन्क्रीट वी आर टेकिंग cement aggregate and water and admixtures by weight we are taking, and that is called as the batching of your concrete. And then in different type of mixer we are mixing the concrete. Previously the hand mix are very common when the mechanical tools are not available, but nowadays varying many types of mixers are available and we are using for mixing of the concrete. Then also we have seen the workability of your concrete and different tests on the workability of your concrete. Also we have seen the factors affecting the workability of concrete and seen cohesion, the addition between the ingredients of your concrete in freeze state is called as cohesion. And segregation means the separation of ingredient of your concrete. So many such characteristics and properties of infrared state we have seen and studied. Also, what is the maturity rule of concrete we have seen? Yani kitne time mein concrete hard hoga, strength gain karega, it is termed as the maturity of your concrete. That also we have seen in the unit number 2. And also we have solved example on the maturity rule during the class. And in third unit, hardened concrete properties, we have seen the strength of concrete. So after hardened, after 28 days curing of the concrete, it gained the desired strength what we want. So that is strength of concrete. Generally we are measuring in compressive strength of concrete, because the strength of concrete in compression is very large as compared to the tension, and we are considering concrete as a compression member in RCC also. And to resist the compression we are using concrete, and to resist the tension we are using steel in RCC. This combination, why we are doing this combination? Because the thermal expansion of these two materials are almost the same. That's why it is used combinedly for RCC work. तो जब भी स्ट्रेंथ हमें बोलूँगा वहाँ पर कॉम्प्रेसिव स्ट्रेंथ आपको कंसिडर करना चाहिए, बिकॉज द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट जनरली मेजर एज इट्स स्ट्रेंथ इन कॉम्प्रेशन. तो फैक्टर्स अफेक्टिंग स्ट्रेंथ, मैनी फैक्टर्स डिपेंड ऑन द टाइप ऑफ सीमेंट एग्रीगेट्स एंड प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एग्रीगेट ऑल्सो अफेक्ट द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ कॉन्क्रीट. Then we have seen the macro cracking stress-strain relationship also of your concrete, and also we have seen the tensile strain relationship with compressive strength and impact strength, abrasion resistance, creep in concrete due to sustained load, and shrinkage it may be during the drying of your concrete. Or long tough effect also we are considering in the shrinkages also. So up till this, yani up to this we have shrinkage in concrete, we have completed our syllabus. Now in coming lecture we will see the testing of hardened concrete, and that is destructive and non-destructive test, and that test is on the concrete we will see in the coming lectures, and that will help you how to test the concrete and how to find the strength of concrete by destructive and non-destructive testing. So up till this hardened concrete properties, till the shrinkage properties, we have finished our syllabus of concrete technology. But still I have not shared you due to your in examination, the assignments and the quizzes. But coming lecture before the next week, inshallah, I will share with you on Google Classroom the lecture material and also the MCQs on unit number 1 and unit 2. Then we will put the unit test on unit 1 and 2 in the form of quiz. The MCQs will be provided. You have to study hard, understand it. You have to search on your own the answers. I will not provide the answer to you. So after studying you will get the answer, right answer. I will not provide answer to you. An online quiz session will be there any day, and I will inform you a day before, and you have to answer the online quiz also, and whoever join I will write their name and roll number. These people are attempting the online quizzes and offline quizzes. So it is necessary to all the students to attend the whatever test we are conducting internally or online quizzes. Many online quizzes on internet are available, but these quizzes we will conduct through the online and offline both as the time permits. तो यहाँ तक हमारा सिलेबस कंप्लीट हो गया था, यूनिट नंबर 1, यूनिट नंबर 2 और यूनिट नंबर 3. अगर आपको ये तीनों यूनिट में से कोई बात पूछना है तो यू कैन आस्क, देन अदरवाइज आई विल प्रोसीड. तो ऑनलाइन लेक्चर जो हमारे हो चुके हैं, वापस से आई विल शो यू, एंड दिस आर द प्रैक्टिकल लिस्ट ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल इन योर सिलेबस. सर्टेन प्रैक्टिकल्स आर डेमो, एंड दिस टू डेमोज ऑलरेडी वी आर डन इन द क्लासरूम, एंड मेनी सच डेमोज आर अवेलेबल. एंड इफ द पेंडेमिक सेमिशन इज देयर, देन ऑल practical we will conduct by demo mode only, and you have to complete the whatever the task and quizzes ask to fulfill that experiment, so that your learning will be continue in this pandemic also. But I am aware that the people, they are taking easy of this subject, do the theory subject. So a student should remember that this subject is very important for scoring marks to improve your result. Don't avoid that, and it is useful in daily activity of your civil engineering. If you are going for a steel structure, the foundations are RCC. If you are going for RCC, then concrete is must. So these subjects are having very important in civil engineering program. Otherwise, you will not be the good civil engineer if you skip learning this subject. Okay. So this is unit number 2. Here, from lecture number 15, we have started the online classes, and in that class we have seen the bleeding and lightens and test on the fresh concrete. Bleeding is the water in the concrete make a passage and come up over the concrete layer, and that cause the path and weaken the concrete section through the aggregate surfaces. And lightens means that after drying this water, the white patches and some dry cements are available over the surface of the concrete, that is called as lightens. And different tests on concrete we have seen. These are the examples of lightens and different tests on concrete: slump test, compaction factor test, flow test, VV consistometer test, Kelly ball test. All these tests we have seen in our these lectures. But still the marking is there. And also I have shown the values of slump and degree of workability and values of compaction factor. And that is very important. You have to remember these things for your MCQs. Also, the video lectures are available on internet on each test. You can go and you can study. That is the demonstration lectures, and that will help you for preparation of your examination, as well as you can come to know or learn how to test the concrete in fresh state. So many such tests. This is flow table test, and then different flow tables are there, and many such lectures we have completed. VV consistometer test, Kelly ball test, we are described in lecture number 16. So all these tests you can do in laboratory on field also. This test is very Kelly ball test is very easy to perform. Certain limitations are there, but it is very good to perform on the sites. Then we have seen some another properties of your fresh concrete and the maturity of concrete, effect of temperature on maturity, and also calculate maturity of concrete by using Plowman equation. So all this we have gone through that, and this is the Plowman equation and the constants A and B, and it is given based on the strength, 28 days strength of concrete and maturity of concrete. Also, we have seen the examples on the maturity rule and how to find the maturity of the concrete. If you know the maturity of concrete at 28 days, for other days maturity we can able to find by the Plowman equation. So we have seen, and I also given you assignment 1, and you have solved this example. Then we have seen other we have started the hardened concrete properties, and strength of concrete in compression is the strength of concrete generally measures. And then you have seen the factors affecting the strength of concrete. It is many factors, that is what which type of molds we are using, their effects, water to cement ratio, jelly space ratio, age, aggregate, moisture content, cement content, type of cement, all these admixtures, mixing water, curing time, and testing fiber, and all this affect the strength of concrete. And we have seen this, the this chart also, the factors affecting the strength of your concrete. With the strength of concrete, many factors, production factor, modulus of elasticity, particle size, concentration of chemical composition, surface characteristic of cement and aggregates, then types of cement, age of the paste, curing condition, and admixture dosage, all these are the effect. Also the porosity, water cement ratio, moisture content, water absorption, etc. All these properties affecting the strength of your concrete. So it is very large, but you should know all the factors related to the strength of your concrete, because main is the compressive strength of concrete, and another properties or other properties are depend on the strength. We have also seen the factor affecting strength in detail, and micro cracking and stress strength relationship of concrete at the last. The influence size of specimen. So many things, this is the micro cracking and the stress strength curve we have seen, and also we have seen the relationship of concrete in tension and compressive strength. Also we have seen the abrasion resistance required for the industrial flooring on roads and highways we are making with the concrete nowadays. Also the impact resistance needed for industrial flooring and during the working at the site, and the creep, the deformation into the concrete due to the sustained load, creep we have seen. And then in last lecture number 22, we have seen the shrinkage and elasticity, that is elastic modulus of your concrete. So up to this unit number 3, halfway we have covered the syllabus of concrete technology, and from next lecture onward we will start the further test on the concrete, that is destructive and non-destructive test after hardening. So in the hardened state, whatever test we are doing, we will see in the coming lectures. So thank you for joining today. So we will stop here and we will continue in the next class. Anything you have to ask, Yogesh? Any other student, you have to ask anything? Otherwise, we will stop today and we will continue further lectures from the next Monday onwards. Okay, by mistake, on Saturday there is first lecture written. That lecture will not be, because I have another class lecture that is overlap, so that should be kept in mind. On Saturday, the first lecture is not mine. Okay, it is by mistake on timetable. So thank you for joining today.